one fall, and it's for the Lucha Underground Championship. Per order of Dario Cueto, there must be a winner. Introducing first, the challenger, accompanied by Katrina. From beyond the grave, Mil Muertes.
Welcome back. This is our main event here at Ultima Lucha. Mil Muertes, the challenger, against the champion, Prince Puma.
6'1", 250 pounds of hulking humanity that is the Thousand Deaths, Mil Muertes. His chance for glory tonight, with Katrina by his side, and that rock, the power it carries, Matt, can he get past the champion Prince Puma here tonight?
Well, last week, Katrina led the Disciples of Death to Trios Championship victory. It would be wonderful for Katrina to hold all of the gold here in Lucha Underground.
Always a dark, boding feeling comes over the temple when Mil Muertes is here.
As the damsel of death begins to unwrap her monster, Mil Muertes prepares for the biggest match of his career.
And his opponent, the champion from Boyle Heights, Los Angeles, California, Prince Puma!
And ladies and gentlemen, there you see our young champion, Prince Puma. He has defeated Fenix, Drago, King Cuerno, Hernandez, Cage, Johnny Mundo, Chavo Guerrero. All of those matches, Konnan was by his side. Tonight, this young warrior goes into battle alone, and many experts are questioning if this kid has it, if this kid can pull off the impossible and defeat the man of a thousand deaths.
Prince Puma, the man who Konnan said was born to be a Lucha Libre legend. It's in his blood. But as Matt said, no Konnan here ringside tonight with Prince Puma. How will that affect the champion's performance? For the first time ever, he won't have Konnan's final advice in his ear. And look at Mil Muertes just eyeing down Prince Puma. The size difference between these two, Muertes at about 250 pounds. Puma at 170 pounds, soaking wet.
The rookie champion, Prince Puma, has held his title since Aztec Warfare. Puma has faced and defeated all that have challenged him. But tonight, Prince Puma faces his biggest and most dangerous challenge, the man of a thousand deaths, Mil Muertes. Tonight, Puma will be without his mentor, Konnan. Tonight, the champion Puma goes it alone. One of these men will walk out of Ultima Lucha tonight in possession of the Aztec gold and the title of Lucha Underground Champion. Break this down, please.
The time for talk is over, and size and strength of Muertes versus the aerial ability of Prince Puma. And both men train toe to toe. You've got to feel that Puma's going to draw the short straw in this exchange. Stumps here from Mil Muertes.
Well, early on, this is where we see the lack of Konnan, because Konnan would be advising Puma to keep the speed going, increase the space. This is where Puma is most effective.
Nice takedown there from the head scissors and a drop kick from Puma.
No, Muertes stays standing.
Drives him over the top rope and onto the floor. Another display of strength from the massive Mil Muertes.
Mil has only suffered defeat at the hands of Fenix, but since returning from grave consequences, the man of a thousand deaths seems rejuvenated, reborn, almost unstoppable. Puma needs to get this match back in the ring. The longer Puma is out on the temple floor, the worse it is for the young champion.
Muertes dragging Puma into the stands. Katrina likes what she sees so far. Dario Cueto said there must be a winner in this contest. You figure they're gonna let it all out here tonight. Championship gold is up for grabs.
Mike, let me ask you, not having Konnan, does that actually make Puma a little more dangerous, almost like an animal backed into a corner?
It may make him take greater risks than if he had Konnan in his corner, but I'd rather have Konnan and his expert advice with me, Matt. Mil Muertes onto those concrete stairs. Puma with a sidekick, a gut-munching rider, and puts Mil Muertes into the stands. Puma elevated here, drops the heel down on the shin of Mil Muertes. Prince Puma in control, the champion rams him head first into those steps.
It's been a wild night here in the temple, a live event experience you'll get nowhere else. This isn't a football stadium. This isn't a bingo hall. This is the dirty and dangerous temple in Boyle Heights. And an argument can be made that the best wrestling in the world today comes straight out of East LA.
And there you see Katrina with the stone. As long as it is raised up high, Mil Muertes' power.
Oh, look at this! Puma's using Katrina as a weapon against her own man!
Oh!
The stiletto's caught Mil Muertes!
That's why he's the
champ. Big uppercut from Prince Puma. Almost took his head off. This monster just unloading on a hapless champion. What's Muertes got planned now? He tells the crowd ringside to clear.
Mil Muertes parks the sea of humanity with an utter wave of his hand.
Sends the champion into the wooden chairs. Prince Puma laid out here, he may be unconscious. Muertes can have his way with him. And look at Katrina. She knows her man is in control.
The believers almost feel as if the Lucha Underground Championship belongs in part to them. They have willed Puma to victory before. Will tonight be the same? Wow!
And that's what Puma's going to rely on, his agility, his speed, and his fighting brain to get past Muertes' size and power.
Arguably one of the best athletes here in Lucha Underground, if not all across the world, our champion, Prince Puma.
She's got a poker face, Katrina, but she must be wondering, how does Mil Muertes rally back from this? And from under the ring, a table. The champion has a table.
We've seen what these tables can do to the luchadors. All throughout the night, the theme has been brutality. But underneath that, the subplot is perseverance. The subplot is fighting spirit. And Prince Puma has all that and then some.
Prince Puma's back into the top of the ring mat. Just crumples in.
Fight, goddammit!
Again, that ungodly power of Mil Muertes proving a difference here. Kick to the guts from Prince Puma. Throws him into the fencing. Beautiful roundhouse kick. And with one strike, Muertes can again change the tempo of this match. Whoa. What is Mil Muertes going to do with those stairs?
You can only imagine what goes through the sick, twisted mind of that man.
Prince Puma could be in a whole lot of bother here. No, he's not going to powerbomb him on the stairs. Surely not! The strength and size of Mil Muertes, because Muertes is manhandling it. He's got a chair now. Beautiful dropkick.
Almost out of desperation by the champion. It's as if he can hear Konnan's voice in his head.
Puma buying himself a few more seconds to try and regain his composure.
Champion.
Oh! Oh! Into the chair.
The stone held high.
Mil Muertes tried back onto the champion. Prince Puma's out here. He's astral traveling.
And now Mil takes the carcass of Prince Puma, puts it back into the ring.
Is Puma starting to see his championship gold slip away from him? He's just unresponsive here, the champ.
With every successful title defense, the prestige of the championship as well as the champion increases. Prince Puma's momentum is at an all-time high. He's always found a way to overcome the odds and win.
Mil Muertes has positioned that chair between the ropes. And Puma stops it. Beautiful back elbow from the champ.
Mike, you can talk about size and all the different styles, but you can't measure heart. And heart was what it will come down to in a fight.
Body shots from Prince Puma. Overhand rights here from Bill Muertes. Just hex down to the top of the spine.
Oh, redirection. Block. Puma on his feet.
Yes.
Both men down on the canvas. Bill Muertes in agony. Can Prince Puma find his second wind?
Look at the space between the two luchadores. That definitely benefits the quicker Prince Puma. As the space increases, the energy rises here in the temple.
Both men back to their feet. Oh, Puma, nice elbow. Rolls back to center ring. Big right hand, smack bang, and he knocked him out.
Straight right cross, and the champ is down.
Katrina plays with Mil Muertes. He charges the cross. Oh!
Here we go.
Look at the strength now of Prince Puma.
Oh!
Down goes Mil Muertes.
Is it enough? Leg is hit. Two.
Well, open the fringe. Mil Muertes may be out cold, but he still could not find the pin. Prince Puma.
Lucha continue out here as Prince Puma rises to his feet.
Come on, you can do it, Puma. Do what you've done your whole life now. Fight.
Puma could be positioning Muertes for the 630, which if you've never seen before, prepare to be captivated by the things that the human body can do. Mil blocks the kick, spins Puma around, goes for the punch. Puma blocked it, Puma on the move, kicks Mil up. Oh, big forearm there. Cover, two, no.
Agonizingly close to Mil Muertes. It was Mil seconds away from championship gold. And Muertes, now in control. Puma is hurt.
Mil Muertes has dominated the competition here in Lucha Underground. But Neil has never faced anyone with the resiliency of Prince Puma.
The temple out of their seats. Neil just throwing Puma into the turnbuckle. Big clotheslines now. Those forearms across the throat of the champion. The head rocking back on Prince Puma time and time again. And he just collapses to the canvas like a rag doll.
And Mike, the believers seem to be separated here, divided in their allegiance.
You hear the chants for Mil Muertes on one side. The chants for Prince Puma coming from the other side. Whip into the ropes now. Catches the kick, ducks under. Nice work from Muertes. Setting up Puma for the ride. Puma drops out the back door to the Prince. Beautiful Yoko Getty sidekick. Look at that! The acrobatics from Prince Puma turn the tide again.
The champ is on his own and seems to be doing just fine as Prince Puma now tries to drag Mil Muertes to his feet. Suplex with the bridge, shoulders are down, Puma floats over. The strength of Prince Puma, almost supernatural. It's that championship drive that keeps this kid alive. Cover here. Two. No.
Right shoulder up just in time for Mil Muertes. You can see the look of concern on the face of Katrina. That poker face of hers was broken. She knows her man was in genuine trouble. Both men laid out here. The toll that took on Prince Puma to get Mil Muertes up high. And of course, the toll the impact took on the Goliath Muertes.
The stone held high again. And it's no coincidence that Mil Muertes begins to stir. Cacophony of song that comes from the believers. May it be a funeral dirge or a victory song, we'll find out.
Let's go, Puma!
put onto the apron. Muertes with a stunning right hand.
Just buckled him at the knees with that right hand. Mil Muertes still trying to catch his breath here. Tries to grab a hold of the champion, takes a kick to the neck for his troubles. Oh, how about that?
Like, how many shots to the jaw can you take?
Begin to change.
250-pound cannonball.
Yes, they are.
Careering into a 170-pound champion, breaking him in half.
The believers are going to tear the temple down.
Powerball through the table.
And you have to ask yourself, what would Konnan be doing right now? What would Konnan be saying to Prince Puma?
The strength again from Mil Muertes puts the champion back in the ring. Is this the time for Muertes to become the champion?
No!
Puma's still here! Prince Puma's not going to wave the red flag. He's not going to go quietly into the night. He's still here, the champion. Finishing move of his.
Oh, look at that. Muertes with his thumb in Puma's mouth. Oh! Separated shoulder right there. This has got to be it.
Real Muertes, absolute powerhouse.
Muertes now crawling like maggots in the grave.
They call him a thousand deaths, and it seems that's what Prince Puma has suffered tonight. Time and time again, he has been on the fringe of losing his championship.
Yet he keeps on fighting.
Well, that's how Prince Puma has lived his entire championship reign, on the edge.
Super kick from Prince Puma. Mil Muertes still on his feet here, though. That's three kicks in a row to the big man. The jump-turning roundhouse, and down goes Mil.
And look at where Mil landed, right in perfect position for the 630. Prince Puma, this is how he won the championship. It would be oh so fitting to close Ultima Lucha this way. The champion, Prince Puma, stands high above the temple. Here we go! Moved out of the way of a second one, and now the cold dead hand of Mil Muertes emerges from the soil. Muertes with the spear.
He cut him in half with that spear. The champion laid out. Pandemonium here. And a stomp, and he grabs the throat.
Muertes now gripping the throat of Prince Puma, holding Puma's life in his hands. Flatliner.
Is this it? Will
he
become
here.
The champion?
One, two, no!
Prince Puma gets out of the pendant flatliner. Amazing, amazing.
The champ still has some fight in him. Who knows what's left in the heart of Prince Puma, but we're gonna find out together.
Oh!
Big right hand to the kisser from Mil.
Puma may be out from that shot.
Caught him with his mouth open. Definitely give him a broken jaw right there.
Nobody has ever kicked out of the flatliner. Not until tonight. Not until the champion, Prince Puma. These head kicks break the hold.
And to my recollection, no one's ever kicked out of the 630 either, so now all bets are off.
What a championship match. An all-time classic. Prince Puma back to his feet. Hip smack, bang on the jaw.
The only thing holding Mil Muertes partially up is that middle rope.
What else can Puma pull out of his bag? How many times can you use the same weapon if it was ineffective?
Oh, that uppercut, beautifully done from Bill Muerte.
Those right hands have constantly been a theme in this match. They've constantly turned the tide for Mil Muertes. Something so simple like a clubbing right hand to the jaw.
But let's not forget, this is a fight, and it's for more than just Aztec gold. This is personal.
Headbutts here off the top rope, and Mil takes a trip to the canvas. What's Prince Puma got in mind now?
Muerte's victory, the lick of death. This time on to the former champion, Prince Puma.
You've got to wonder how not having Konnan by his side tonight affected the performance of Prince Puma.
And here come the trio's champions, the disciples of death. And now it seems that Katrina's dark stranglehold over the temple, while it's draped in gold, may very well be ruled with an iron fist. The age of death begins here in Lucha Underground. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Ultima Lucha. For Mike Schiavello, I'm Matt Stryker. We say thank you so much. We'll see you next time. Good night.